So we're going to generalize this a little bit more. We've just been using the limit as delta x approaches 0 or as h approaches 0, depending on which notation we were using. And what we talked about was that was m, which was the slope. What we didn't talk about is that that was considered a derivative. So differentiation is about half of what we're going to learn in this class. There's quite a bit to it. What we're going to do, again, we're looking for the slope of the tangent line through differentiation. So we're just going to be using the same function that we used before. Notice the only difference is I'm using x instead of a number, and instead of c, I'm just using x. Ways that you might know that they're asking for the derivative. This is the derivative of y with respect to x. Y prime is the same as the derivative of f of x. You might also see it written this way, d over dx, and then the function f of x, which means find the derivative of the function f of x. Or d sub x, y, means find the derivative of y with respect to x. They all mean exactly the same thing. I just want you to be familiar with all of the notation. So we can see essentially what we're doing is creating a new function. We started out with a function, we're finding the derivative of the function, which is a new function, and that new function gives the slope of the tangent line to the graph at any point x. So think about when we did method two just a few moments ago, where I came out with my slope being 2c, and then I just took the c value, which was the x value, and plugged it in. That's exactly what I'm talking about. So I'm not talking about something new. I just want to develop that concept a little bit further. So again, we're learning how to find the derivative. We know that that represents the slope of the tangent line at the point x or c. It can also be used to find the instantaneous rate of change, or what we'll just call rate of change, of one variable with respect to another. So that's more of the application of what we're doing. Some of the other words you might see thrown around is differentiation, which of course is just the process of finding the derivative. If something is differentiable, it means you can find the derivative of it. And it is differentiable on an open interval a comma b when it's differentiable at every point on the interval. So we'll talk a little bit in a little bit about differentiability and continuity and how those two things are related. But I just wanted to throw some of that terminology in there you'll hear me say to make sure you understand what I'm saying. So let's take a look at an example. And again, this shouldn't look different than anything that we've already done, except that we're going to be using x instead of c. So previously we found f of c plus h minus f of c over h. Or remember that before we said it's okay if you use delta x instead of h. Well, now we're just saying it's okay if you use x instead of c. So it's really the exact same thing. So that's our first step, is really just to write it out again. Notice in front, I'm using that f prime of x, which just means that's the derivative. So again, this is using the definition of a derivative. This one's going to be a little bit trickier, only because my function is a cubic function, which means when I'm plugging in a binomial into a cubic function, I'm going to have to cube a binomial, which is super fun, as we know. So now what I'm doing is I'm taking x cubed plus 2x, and I'm plugging in x plus delta x. So this is x cubed plus 2x, and then I'm subtracting my second function, which is f of x. Whoops, I meant to do a different color. F of x. So I'm subtracting this function. And then from here, it's just algebra, which hopefully you're really, really good at by now. So I'm going to cube this, which is the hardest part. And again, if you need to, off to the side, take x plus, and again, this is where h is nice instead of delta x, and x plus delta x, and x plus delta x, and FOIL these two, and then once you get that solution, multiply it by x plus delta x. I'm not going to go through all of that just for the sake of time and space. So all of this to here is what I got when I cubed it. And then of course I took 2 times x and 2 times delta x. So that's the rest of the blue. And then I'm subtracting x cubed and subtracting 2x, so I distributed that negative. And now that everything is just a single value, I can start looking at what can be reduced. So it looks like I have 3x squared delta x, and so I've just rewritten that 3x squared delta x, because my x cubed and my minus x cubed canceled, so that was my first term. And then I had 3x delta x squared. Notice delta x is in parentheses, and again this is where h is handier than delta x. Then I've got delta x cubed, and then I have 2x, but I also have a minus 2x, so those two canceled. So I have plus 2 delta x. And again, my denominator, delta x, hasn't changed. And it can't change because I can't plug in 0 for delta x. So let's continue. Each of my terms has a delta x, so notice I've just factored out a delta x, which means then I can cancel it, which means now I have all of the stuff that was left over. And from here, I can take delta x and plug in 0 and simplify. So I get that f prime of x is 3x squared plus 2. Notice that is a function. So the derivative of my function, x cubed plus 2x, is 3x squared plus 2. And again, this is using the definition of a derivative. So later on, I'm going to show you an easier way. But this is important for you to understand that this is where all of this comes from. At this point, if they wanted to say, I want you to find the derivative at the point 7, 9, then, which I'm not even sure that that's a point on my graph, I was just making something up, I would plug in whatever value I wanted for x, and I could find the slope at that point. And here we have a couple of examples of exactly what I was just talking about. Because I have found that f prime of x equals 3x plus 2, now I can find the slope of the tangent line at x equals 1, x equals negative 3, or x equals 5 by simply plugging those x values into the function to find those slopes. Last one for you to try, and again, I want you to try to find the derivative of my function f of x as a function. So I'm not asking you to find the value of the slope at a certain point, I just want the derivative. So use the process we just went through. When you're done, press play to see how you did. Let's take a look at the work together. Again, this I just write to remind you that this is where we're starting. Notice I've used h this time instead of delta x, which makes it a little bit easier to work with. But whichever one floats your boat, that's what you should use. Keep in mind, again, I didn't point this out specifically on the last question, but I have to keep writing limit or it's wrong. I have to keep writing limit until I'm able to physically plug 0 in for h. Otherwise, you're going to get docked points for sure. So again, I'm using the function x squared plus 2x plus 1, and I'm replacing this with all of this, and then I've got minus f of x, which is minus all of what the original function is. Then it's just math from here. So again, I'm foiling x plus h quantity squared is x plus 2x h plus h squared, and then I'm distributing 2, so 2x plus 2h plus 1. And then I am distributing a minus, so minus x squared minus 2x minus 1. Once everything is out of the parentheses, then I just look for things I can cancel. X squared and minus x squared plus 1 and minus 1 minus 2x and plus 2x leaves me with this guy, and this guy. All of those guys have an h in there, so I'm going to take that h out, so that I can then cancel it. Once I get to this point, now I can plug 0 in for h. So the moment I plug a 0 in for h is the moment I stop writing this. So notice on my next line, I plugged in the 0 to get 2x plus 2, and that's when I didn't have to write the limit anymore. So my derivative is 2x plus 2.